Philippine authorities rule out overloading in the Iloilo Guimaras Sea tragedy that has left over 20 dead. We're now joined on the line by Philippine Coast Guard spokesperson, Captain Arman Balilo. Captain Balilo, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Ron. Good afternoon to your televiewers.
Now, we heard the number of people, the number of survivors, the number of dead and the number of missing earlier in a press conference this afternoon. Have there been changes? Have there been more people who were rescued or casualties that were retrieved since this afternoon?
That's true, Ron. The incident has a running figure, and we continually update every time there's a development. And as of the moment, based on all the rescue units involved, Bob's figure, the death toll now is 28, and there are 5 more missing.
28 people dead, 5 more missing. With regard to the search and rescue operations, is the Coast Guard encountering any problem with that? How is the weather in the area?
The weather is getting better there, Ron, and we are continuing the search and rescue operations. We are going to continue it until such time that we would be able to account all those 5 missing.
Okay, sir. Now, we do want to ask more about the investigation. We do know that, of course, everything is preliminary today, but there have been reports that it was a squall that was responsible for overturning those 3 boats. Now, let's talk about more about this squall. Is it a common occurrence in that stretch during a rainy season, during this kind of weather?
Not sure if it's a common occurrence, Ron, because this is, for me, this is my first time to encounter squall in this part of the country, mm-hmm. in Iloilo Strait. I have 1 or 2 record of squall incident where accident happened after the squall. Mm-hmm. One in Bicol and one in Central Visayas. Other than that, I have no recollection of anymore and of other incident.
And in those past incidents that you mentioned, the boats were overturned as well or capsized because of a squall?
Yeah, but fortunately, no casualties involved.
Which leads us to questioning maybe if the protocols were properly followed for these trips. Is the Coast Guard looking into that as well?
Yes, this is one incident that we should revisit our protocol in the area. We should adapt to the changing weather pattern and this kind of occurrence. And that is part of the investigation. Probably the investigating team would recommend changes in the regulations.
Okay, how long can before the Philippine Coast Guard can come out with the results of their investigation? We understand, of course, that the priority is search and rescue as of now. But yes. Is there a timetable that the PCG is following for this one?
I'm sure they have a timetable, but I have not spoken to the investigators yet, Ron. Mm-hmm. But the guidance of the Commandant Admiral Elson Hermuino is to fast-track the investigation so we could give closure to this incident and make some changes in the protocols that we are using.
Subscribe to the official ANC YouTube channel, and for more ANC videos, just click the I button.